हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिसेस माधवी सालोडकर। टुडे वी हैव टू सी सम बेसिक प्रॉब्लम्स बेस्ड ऑन CDR, STDR एंड देन वी विल सी द कंसेप्ट ऑफ बर्थ रेट्स और फर्टिलिटी रेट्स। सी द नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल, कैलकुलेट STDR फॉर डिस्ट्रिक्ट ए एंड बी and compare them. So district A values are given: number of persons in 1000, number of deaths. Same way for district B also, we have number of persons in 1000 and number of deaths, and standard population values are given separately. So see the calculations for district A. Age group, population is given as 2000, total deaths are 50. So mortality rate is equal to 50 upon 2000 into 1000, that is equal to 25. So MIA into PIS, so 25 into 2 lakhs becomes 50 lakhs. Then age group 10 to 65, population is 7000, number of deaths are 49. So mortality rate is 49 upon 7000 into 1000, that is nothing but 7. Seven into population is 580,000. So 7 into 580,000 becomes 4060000. Then next age group is 55 and above. Total population is 1000. Number of deaths are 25. So mortality rate is equal to 25 upon 1000 into 1000. So that becomes 25. 25 into population value is 220,000. So as the value becomes 55 lakhs. And the total of MIA into PIS, the value is 1456,000. So STDR for population A is equal to summation MIA into PIS upon summation PIS, which is equal to 1456,000 divided by 1000000. So the answer is 14.56. Then see the calculations for district B. Age group is 0 to 10. Population is 1000. Number of deaths are 20. So mortality value becomes 20 upon 1000 into 20. So answer is 20. MIB into PIS, the value is 20 into 2 lakhs. So that becomes 40 lakhs. Age group is 10 to 55. Population is 3000. Deaths are 30. So mortality rate is 30 upon 3000 into 1000. So answer is 10. 10 into PIS value is 580,000. So that becomes 580,000,000. Then next age group is 55 and above. Total population is 2000. Number of deaths are 40. So mortality rate is nothing but 40 upon 2000 into 1000, which is equal to 20. So MIB into PIS, the value becomes 20 into 220,000. So that becomes 44 lakhs. And if we take the total of last column, that value becomes 1420,000 divided by total of standard population, which is equal to 1000000. So which can be considered as 14.20 per 1000. So since STDR for district B is less than STDR for district A, district B is more healthier than district A. Next example, compare death rates of town A and B, taking town A to be standard population and using the following data. So age group is given. Town A values are given, town B values are given. So for town A, For age group below 10, the population is 30,000 and number of deaths are 720. For town A, for age group 10 to 40, population is 40,000, number of deaths are 800. For town A, age group is above 40, the population is 20,000 and deaths are 560. For town B, the values are also given. Age group is below 10, population is 80,000, number of deaths are 2,000. For age group 10 to 40, for town B, the population is 1,04,000 and total deaths are 2,080. For age group above 40, for town B, the population is 16,000 and total number of deaths are 1,080. So, we will see the calculations. So, we know that STDR for population A, the formula is summation MIA into PIS upon summation PIS. So, calculations for town A. Age group is below 10. Population is 30,000. Deaths are 720. Then we will calculate MIA. How do we calculate MIA? 720 divided by 30,000 into 1,000. So, answer becomes 24. 24 into standard population. Population is 30,000. So 24 into 30,000, answer becomes 720,000. Then for group 10 to 40, population is 4,000, deaths are 800. MIA, that is nothing but mortality for town A, 800 divided by 4,000 into 1,000. So, answer becomes 20. So, 20 multiplied by the standard population, that is nothing but 40,000. So, the total value becomes 8 lakhs. Then, above 40, total population is 20,000. Deaths are 560. So, MIA value is calculated as 560 upon 20,000 into 1,000. So, answer is 28. So, 28 into standard population is 20,000. So, the answer becomes 5,60,000. Take the total of last column. So, total becomes 2,080,000. And population total is 90,000. So, for STDR, for region A is equal to summation MIA into PIS upon summation PIS. So the value is 23.1111. Then calculations for town B. Age group, population, deaths are given. So for below 10, population is 80,000, deaths are 2,000. So MIB becomes 2,000 upon 80,000 into 1,000. So, answer becomes 25. And 25 into PIS. PIS value is 3,000. So, 25 into 30,000, not 3,000, it is 30,000. So, 25 into 30,000 becomes 7,50,000. Next age group is 10 to 40. The population is 1,04,000. Deaths are 2050. So, MIP value is calculated as 2050 divided by 1400, 1,04,000 into 1000. So, answer becomes 20. 20 into 40,000. 40,000 is the population of standard population, that is town A population. So, the answer becomes 8 lakhs. Then age group for above 40, total population is 16,000. Number of deaths are 1,080. So, MIB value becomes 1,080 divided by 16,000 into 1,000. So the value is 67.5. 67.5 into 20,000. This is the population, standard population from town A. See, this is 20,000. So 13,50,000. That will be the final answer. If we take the total becomes 29 lakhs, and total of standard population is 90,000. So 29 lakhs divided by 90,000, the answer is 32.2222. So compare these values. STDR for region A is 23 point something, and STDR for division B is 32.22. So we can say that as STDR for region A is less than STDR for district B, population A is healthier than population B. Let us see birth rates or fertility rates. First type of birth rate is crude birth rate, which is denoted by CBR. It is the simplest measure of fertility rate or birth rate. CBR is equal to total number of live births in a specified year divided by total population in a specified year into 1000. Merits: it is easy to calculate and simple to understand. Demerits: first demerit, crude birth rate provides very approximate fertility rate. Second demerit, it ignores age and sex distribution. Third demerit, according to the definition of rate of vital event, the denominator of the rate of vital event should be number of persons exposed to the risk of occurrence of the event. In this case, entire population is considered and only a part of it, that is women in the childbearing age group, is exposed to the chance of reproduction. So it is the serious drawback of the method. CBR generally lies between 10 to 55 per 1000 persons. Then next is general fertility rate, GFR. So GFR is equal to total live births divided by total female population in the reproductive age into 1000. So while computing GFR, denominator is taken as number of females in the reproductive age group, because it is a group exposed to the reproduction. So in general, reproductive age group is considered to be 15 to 49 years or 15 to 45 years. It is also called a childbearing period. Third type of fertility rate is age-specific fertility rate, which is called as ASFR. Suppose BI is equal to number of births to the female in the ith group, PIF is equal to female population in the ith age group, then age-specific fertility rate is equal to BI upon PIF into 1000. Remarks: first, if we take age group as a single year, then it is called as annual ASFR. If age group removes the drawback present in GFR, but for comparison purpose, we require a single value, an approximate and useful method to combine the age specific fertility rate to a single value is total fertility rate. So total fertility rate is nothing but, it gives the average number of children born to 1000 women in the entire reproductive age period. If C is the width of an age group, then ASFR is the average fertility rate for the corresponding C years. Thus, total fertility rate is equal to summation C into ASFR, which can be written as C into summation ASFR, which is equal to width of age group into summation ASFR. Interpretation: total fertility rate gives the total number of children born to per 1000 women in the entire reproductive age period. For example, TFR is equal to 2200 means on an average 1000 female over their complete reproductive period give birth to 2200 offsprings. So in other words, every woman gives birth to 2.2 children in her entire reproductive period. Limitations of TFR. In computing TFR, we assume that all the women will survive up to the end of the reproductive age period, which is not noticed in reality. Second limitation, we consider entire female population in the reproductive age period. Actually, in computing GFR as well as ASFR, we have to consider only married female population. To overcome the drawback, sometimes by considering married female population in the reproductive age period, general married fertility rate, that is GMFR, age specific married fertility rate, that is ASMFR, and total marital fertility rate, that is TMFR, are separately calculated. Then third limitation, TFR does not consider effect of infertility. See the example. Compute crude birth rate, GFR, age specific fertility rate, and TFR for the following data. So age group wise, number of female population and number of births are given. So age group 15 to 19, number of women are 24,000, number of birth is equal to 800. For age group 20 to 24, number of women are 20,000 and birth are 2,400. For age group 25 to 29, number of women are 15,000, number of births are 2,000. For age group 30 to 34, number of women are 12,000, number of births are 600. For age group 30 to 39, number of women are 6,000, number of births are 120. Same way, for age group 40 to 44, number of women are 4,000, number of births are 10. It is also given that total population is 186,300. So, first of all, we will find crude birth rate, which is nothing but total number of births divided by total population into 1000. So we will take the total 800 plus 2400 plus 20,000, plus 2000 plus 600 plus 120 plus 10. So the total is 5930 divided by 186,300, because total population is given, into 1000. It should be 1000, not 100. So the answer is 31.830 per 1000. Then we will calculate age specific fertility rate. So write down age group, number of women, number of births, and ASFR is equal to BI upon PIF into 1000. So for 15 to 19, total number of women are 24,000, number of births are 800. So we will find age specific fertility rate as 800 upon 24,000 into 1000. So answer is 33.333. Then for age group 20 to 24, number of women are 20,000, number of births are 2,400. So fertility rate is given by 2,400 divided by 20,000 into 1,000. So answer is 120. Same way, we can calculate for age group 20 to 29, number of women are 15,000, number of births are 2,000. So 2,000 divided by 15,000 into 1,000, that becomes age specific fertility rate. The answer is 133.3333. So 30 to 34, number of women 12,000, number of births 600. So ASFR is nothing but 600 upon 12,000 into 1,000. So answer is 50. then 35 to 39, total women are 6,000, number of births are 120. So the age specific fertility rate comes out to be 20. For age group 40 to 44, number of women are 4,000, number of births are 10. So ASFR is 10 upon 4,000 into 1,000. So answer is 2.5. So first of all, we'll take the total of number of women. So total is 81,000 women we have. Number of births we have 5,930. And total of ASFR is 359.1666. So GFR is equal to total births divided by female population in the reproductive age group into 1,000. So the answer is 5930 divided by 81,000 into 1,000. So which is equal to 73.2099 per 1,000. Then TFR is calculated as C into summation ASFR. So if you observe the age groups 15 to 19, so the class weight is nothing but 5 units and summation ASFR is 359.1666. So TFR can be calculated as 5 into 359.1666. So the answer is 1795.833 per 1,000. See the example for 2 marks. Compute CBR given that the total number of births is 7,200 and total population is 2 lakhs. So CBR is equal to total number of births divided by total population into 1,000, which is equal to 7,200 divided by 2 lakhs into 1,000. So the answer is 36. Same type of example we can see for 2 marks. Compute CBR for the given population if the total birth is 810. So they have given us the age group wise population. 0 to 10 the population is 4,000. 10 to 25 population is 12,000. 25 to 60 population is 6,000. 60 and above the population is 8,000. So we know that crude birth rate is equal to total number of births divided by total population into 1,000. So that is nothing but 810 divided by total of this population is 30,000 into 1,000. So answer is 27.